Good morning, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to the rededication of Simmons Park. I started playing here with when my girls were in softball many, many years ago, and it's amazing what this park looks like today. Great renovation. The municipality decided to put a lot of money in recreation. This is just one of the parks that we're doing. And I definitely want to thank Public Works, because without them, this park would not look anything like this. But this started years ago. It was a neighborhood project. There was a woman that took over the flags down there, and she planted flowers just to make it look nice. And this is the premier park in Bethel Park, without a question. So at this time, I'd like to turn the program over to Council President Tim Myrick.
Thank you, Mayor. Bethel Park is truly a special place, and I'm happy to call it my home. We're here to showcase Bethel Park and some of the recreational facilities and programs, along with highlighting some of the new relationships that we have developed to help improve the quality of life for our residents. We cannot do this alone. We have a number of people that are working together, and I'd like to acknowledge some of the people from Municipal Council and the school district for which, without their support today, would not have happened. Tim Campbell, Jim Hannon, Paul Dixon, Councilman Harrison was unable to make it today, Mark O'Brien, Jim McLean, Lori Gibbons, Mayor Jack Allen, our Municipal Manager and Police Chief Tim O'Connor, our Recreation Director Chuck Stover, and our Public Works Director Susan Dolinar. Also here representing the school board, because this is a joint project, or one of the joint announcements, is Ron Werkmeister and Jim Means. We believe that it is fitting to announce our plans today for the dedication of this at the new playground. We have a lot of things going on, a lot of announcements, some special announcements. To really start the program, I would like to introduce a member of council, Dr. Tim Campbell.
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
I've been practicing medicine for about 35 years, all told. I had a private internal medicine practice down at Mercy Hospital, and I double boarded in hospice and palliative care as well. And I absolutely love my job. Absolutely love my job. I felt like I got to go to work instead of I had to go to work. And my patients were some of the best friends I've ever had over the years. But most of my career was dedicated to taking care of people who suffer from all kinds of illnesses. I mean, you name it. From an internal medicine perspective in hospice, I sometimes saw a lot of the sickest of the sick patients. And I treated a lot of heart failure. I treated heart attacks. I treated liver and kidney disease. I treated strokes, diabetes, and too many cancers than I cared to really have gone treated over the years. And many of these illnesses, they were caused by untreated or undiagnosed high blood pressure, cholesterol, or triglycerides, or untreated diabetes, or folks didn't even know they had diabetes. Sometimes a lot of these folks may have made poor dietary choices, like a high-fat diet or a high-sugar diet. Sometimes they were related to poor lifestyle choices, drugs, alcohol, or smoking. And sometimes they just, you know, some of the things I treated were due to lack of exercise. I felt like we had it all backwards. I felt like it was completely upside down. We could spend thousands and thousands of dollars taking care of patients and treating diseases and giving them thousands of hours worth of health care for something that could have been nipped in the bud. Something that we could have done, just a little bit of preventative medicine would have taken care of it. Or if maybe we'd educated patients a little bit better about their illnesses, or had them exercise more, or did a little bit better job with earlier diagnosis and management. Sometimes all we needed to do was give people the proper tools. Give them the information, put that in front of the patient, and give them more ownership in their health care. And we could have reduced so much illness, so much suffering as a consequence. I can assure you, it is much, much, much better to prevent an illness than to go ahead and treat it. It's much more cost effective, it reduces morbidity, it reduces mortality. So when I was appointed recently to council in Bethel Park, I thought as a doctor I had a kind of a unique skill set that I could bring to the table. About 5 months ago, Council President Tim Mowry approached me about investigating this Live Well Allegheny initiative. And he'd mentioned it was an innovative program to improve the health and the wellness of all Allegheny County residents. It focused on increasing activity, improving our nutrition, eating healthier, increasing our health literacy, and helping people to manage their own health. It was this program was exactly what I was envisioning, what I wanted to do, what I was so frustrated with as a doctor. And what was particularly elegant and amazing about this, Live Well Allegheny dovetailed perfectly into Bethel Park strategic plan. Perfect, hand in glove. We were so impressed. The council passed a resolution on our March 11th meeting of our intention to work with Allegheny County with this initiative, the Live Well Allegheny Initiative. We wanted to work with our school district, our local businesses, and our local healthcare partners, the Montour Trail Council, St. Clair Hospital, who's here with us today, in our vision of Live Well Allegheny, which we're going to call Live Well Bethel Park. The dedication of this playground today is a manifestation of that vision. We've acquired 24 acres last year to add to this beautiful park. We plan to improve and to extend our sidewalks. We want to develop community walking maps. We plan to extend and expand our rail trails and improve and provide connectors into our local parks, the existing parks that we have. We want to support and promote our farmers market. We want to step up and focus on our parks and recreation program. We want to start a healthcare speaker series for education to help people learn a little bit more about diseases and what we could do to prevent them. These are exciting times to be in Bethel Park. And you're going to hear more about two such programs in a little bit. We're going to hear from Chris Beekner, president and CEO of the Allegheny Land Trust, as well as Phil Bulbers from the Montour Trail Council. But first, I have the distinct privilege to introduce our next speaker, Dr. Karen Hacker. Dr. Hacker serves as the Allegheny Health Department Director. We sincerely need to clone this woman. She did her undergraduate at Yale. She did her MD at Northwestern University, got her MPH at Boston University. She's the Executive Director of the Institute of Community Health, Associate Professor of Medicine at Harvard Medical School and School of Public Health, and now is Adjuvant Professor at the University of Pittsburgh, Graduate School of Public Health, and a Visiting Professor at the University of Pittsburgh School of Medicine. Dr. Hacker is the highest ranking official in the Health Department in Allegheny County. She's responsible for overseeing all of its programs and activities. Do you understand why I want to clone this woman? Amazing. And with that, let's give a warm welcome, please, Dr. Karen Hacker.
I don't usually get a great introduction, so thank you. It is such a pleasure to be here today, and look, the sky's even got clear for y'all here today. The Live Well Allegheny campaign that you've been hearing about is something that we started with the county executive literally, I think, within 6 months after I got here in 2013. And the whole purpose of this was, how do we work with 130 different municipal governments to try to surround our citizens with healthy opportunities? The concept being that we just want to make it as easy as possible to have a healthy lifestyle. And what we know is that a lot of our municipalities didn't have the kinds of opportunities and access that other communities did. And so we've been working diligently over the course of the last 5 years to bring them on board. And we're now at, I think, 63 or 64 of our 130 municipalities that have joined. And we are so excited that both Bethel Park and the school district today have joined this initiative and are doing some fantastic things to provide these opportunities for all of their residents. So as you probably know, you heard already from all the fabulous people here about the things that they're doing. We've got this great new park and new land, but there are all kinds of wellness initiatives that are being planned, changes in the sidewalks, trails. We've got the Montour Trail folks here today as well. We weren't even expecting them, so shout out to them. Clearly we know about St. Clair and we work with them. And then also the school districts that's planning everything you can imagine, from running clubs to changes in their school diet, yoga in the schools, a whole variety of things. And these are the kinds of things that are really music to my ears, because I really do believe that we all have to be in this together. This is not something that we at the health department will ever be able to do by ourselves. I think one thing we're very lucky to have here in Allegheny County is so many different organizations, so many different nonprofits, so many different healthcare groups that are invested in these types of activities. And so with their help, our intention is to get all 130 municipalities on board. I can't tell you exactly when that will happen, but if your neighboring communities aren't engaged yet, maybe you can help get them engaged. But also that we will then see the kinds of changes in our population health that we're really interested in. And those include things like changes in nutrition, a decrease in cigarette smoking, and increases in physical activity. And as you heard from our councilman, I'm saying that right, correct? Where did he go? There he is. That as a physician, what you often see are the outcomes of not doing these kinds of preventive strategies. Some people are now referring to sitting as the new smoking. And as our lifestyles become more basically complacent, if one wants to think that way, more focused on computer screens and sitting at a desk, it's going to be even more important that we get up and walk. And these are the type of opportunities that are being made available here in Bethel Park. So we really appreciate it and thank you. And we want to present you with your official plaques. Not sure who should be coming up to receive these. There he is.
Something good, it's me.
All right. So there's Live Well Bethel Park for the community, and then there's for the school district. So join me in giving them a rousing applause for this accomplishment. Thank you.
Thank you very much. They don't want to tell you that I was voted at our last meeting as I'm the before picture on the Live Well Allegheny program. But anyhow, one of the many major things we're going to announce today is Tim had mentioned that we did an expansion, and there's a picture here of Simmons Park. We more than doubled the size of it last year, so you'll give an idea of the property that we own. And also tied into the whole program, as Tim had mentioned, this is kind of outlines the Montour Trail, our sidewalks, our recreational opportunities. We're very fortunate to have a portion of South Park in Bethel Park, so there's a lot of recreational opportunities for us. One project that we started on, I guess is maybe a wish, maybe 6 months ago, maybe a little bit longer, was how do we acquire some property for green space? How do we protect some of the area that hasn't been developed? As many people know, every area that's open, a building seems to be going up. But at this time, I would like to introduce Chris Bigner, who is from the Allegheny Land Trust, has a special announcement for us today.
Thank you, Tim. Hi, everyone. My name is Chris Bigner. I'm the president and CEO of the Allegheny Land Trust, and I just want to thank the council for inviting us here today, and congratulations on your park dedication. The Allegheny Land Trust is a nonprofit organization that conserves and cares for local land for the health and well-being of current and future generations. Over the past 25 years, ALT has permanently protected 2,500 acres of green space in 27 different Allegheny County municipalities. In addition to its recreational and aesthetic benefits, green space is a key part of the solutions to many of the regional issues that we face today, including landslides, flooding, combined sewer overflows, and water and air quality. But despite the declining population, our county is losing an alarming rate of green space at the tune of 2,000 acres every year. You are fortunate, however, that you have a municipality in Bethel Park that recognizes the value of green space to the community and has worked proactively to enhance its existing parks and to protect additional green space for the benefit of the public. The project that we're going to unveil today, it's a working name called Bethel Greenway, presents a rare opportunity to protect 40.5 wooded acres in Bethel Park near the intersection of Route 88 and Connor Road in the municipality's northwest corner, adjacent with Castle Shannon. This large green space is bordered by several resident streets, is within walking distance of thousands of neighbors, and is already crisscrossed with informal walking trails. The land is a relic of the area's industrial past as part of the Molinar Mine Complex and was used from the late 1800s through 1939 and a dumping ground for dirt and rock tailings from the mine. The once large and unsightly mountain of debris has evolved over time into an excellent demonstration of nature's ability to recover itself if given the opportunity. The once imposing tailings pile has been almost completely reclaimed by nature and is now mostly forested by black cherry, sumac and birch trees. Additionally, this property is at the headwaters of the flood-prone Sawmill Run, and thus serves as an important role in sequestering and filtering 3.2 million gallons of rainwater every year. ALT has this property under contract, contingent upon its ability to raise necessary funds by year's end. Fundraising activities include the pursuit of grants, and a community campaign are underway. ALT will own and sustainably manage the new conservation area in perpetuity. Visitors interested in passive recreation and educational pursuits will wait welcome year-round, and the community volunteer involvement will be encouraged. We are working in cooperation with Bethel Park, community members, and civic-minded organizations to raise the funds necessary to permanently protect one of the largest remaining green spaces in the South Hills. So I just want to thank you all again, and we look forward to working with the municipality, all of its partners, and looking forward to a successful project in the end. Thank you.
I must admit, I've driven past the place a million times, I've lived here all my life, and I have not walked it, but I plan on taking a walk up the trails this afternoon with a few of my colleagues. They don't know it yet. Through the investment Bethel Park, or through the last year, we've invested well over $1 million into our park facilities, including the playground here, a number of different amenities. We added some new bathrooms, we updated the bathrooms on the other side. And fortunately, we do have cameras on the park, so if you want to do any damage to our bathrooms, we will get you. Don't you worry. Right, Chief? Thank you. But no, we couldn't have invested this kind of money without help from a number of our elected officials. We have partnered with them to bring in grant money to do a lot of these projects. We can't do it alone. And I think over the last year, we've developed a lot of relationships and new friendships. So at this time, I'd like to introduce, to have some people come up and speak, but our Congressman Mike Doyle.
Thank you. What a great day. Hello, Bethel Park. I want you to know it's a real privilege and pleasure to represent this great community in the United States Congress. This is new territory for me. The new 18th district includes 13 municipalities in the South Hills to go along with the city of Pittsburgh, the Mon Valley, and the eastern suburbs to comprise this new district. So while I've been in Congress a long time, I'm very new to this area. We were looking for an office to service the South Hills, and we thought Bethel Park was the best place for it. Our new South Park, our South Hills office, is on 4705 Library Road. So if you need any services of the federal government, I hope you'll stop by. A local Bethel Park resident will greet you there, as he's one of the people that staffs the office. And we're really looking forward to working with the local government officials and our colleagues in county government and state government to work together for the betterment of this community. It's the partnerships that we form here in Allegheny County and Pittsburgh, I think, that makes us unique in some respects. We work together, and we all work together and push in one direction, good things happen. Dr. Hacker, it's good to see you here today. We all need to use our thumbs less on these devices and our legs more. And this is a beautiful example of how we can do that. When I walk the halls of Congress and go in the elevator, I see all these brilliant young staffers in the elevator. Their heads are down and their thumbs are working those iPhones. And I'll say to them, why don't we all lift our heads up and say hello to one another? And they roll their eyes and look at me like I'm nuts. But I just remember as a kid, the most fun was to get out of the house and go down and play baseball or basketball, because if you stayed in your house, your mother gave you chores to do, so we were looking for ways to get out of the house. Now too many kids are staying inside and they're on video games, and this is a much better option, much better for our health. Bethel Park's a really great community. It's really a pleasure to be out here. I look forward to getting to know you all a lot better. Congratulations to Mayor and Council for what you're doing here in this beautiful rededication of this park. I'm sure any community would love to have something like this. Thanks for inviting me. Have a great day.
Thank you and welcome to Bethel Park. The next I'd like to introduce Natalie Mihalik, state representative from the 40th District.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for having me here today in Bethel Park. It is one of my three townships that I represent, and I think it might be my favorite, especially with the group that's standing behind me here. And we are very excited about this playground. My seven-year-old is currently climbing all over it, and I think she gave me the thumbs up a few minutes ago. So good job, guys. I'm looking forward to partnering with the council and the Allegheny Land Trust as far as state support goes. And just to sort of piggyback on what Congressman Doyle was saying, it is very easy in this modern day when we have so much access to the digital devices, especially as a mom, being so busy, and we're able to, you know, just pass the iPhone or the iPad off to the kids, keep them busy for a minute while we tend to the chores or catch up on work. And it does take effort to get out there and go hiking and, you know, get on the trail. And that's something that's very important and very near and dear to our family. We've already been out there this morning, which is why I appear to be a little disheveled. So I apologize for that. And we'll be back out there this afternoon as long as the rain does hold off. The Montour Trail is one of our favorite spots to go and learn to ride bikes. And it's just, you know, you have to make it a priority, because it's just too easy to pass off that device. So I'm grateful that Bethel is making an effort to get everyone out there, make it easier to access these green spaces. And we're very excited about this particular project to preserve some of that beautiful green space that's in the South Hills. So thank you for having me. Look forward to partnering with you all.
Thank you. I apologize. I would also like to acknowledge our school superintendent, Dr. Joe Pascarella, is here today. Thank you for coming. At this time, I would like to introduce our county council person, Sue Means, who is a lifelong Bethel Park resident.
That's correct. My father moved to Bethel Park when he was three. He is now 98. So our family's been in Bethel Park a long time. So I'm Councilwoman Sue Means. I represent Bethel Park, Upper St. Clair, Mount Lebanon, Bridgeville, and I'm really happy to be here today. This is such a happy day because we are celebrating the revamped park, the beautiful revamped park, and we're celebrating that Bethel Park and the school district have joined the Allegheny County Live Well Initiative. And I'm just so happy that here we are in a park where people can get exercise and lots of exposure to vitamin D. And as a nurse, I know that helps you grow strong bones. And also, as a third degree black belt in karate, I know how good exercise is. Because when you exercise, the blood flows through your body, and all that stress and wear and tear just flows away as all that oxygen goes to every cell in your body. So my final words are, eat right, exercise, and we all will have a happy, healthy life. Congratulations to Bethel Park Municipality and the district, school district. Thank you.
Thank you, Sue. At this time, I would like to introduce our district judge, Ron Arnone, to say a few words.
Thank you, Mr. President. So, I guess, does she kick your butt? Welcome, everyone. Welcome to Bethel Park. I represent Bethel Park and Upper St. Clair as the district judge. Just a few words. First of all, what a great example of collaboration and leadership. And Councilman Mowry, President Mowry, and the council, the mayor, the school district, Allegheny County, the state, the federal government, everyone coming together to work in collaboration to make this all possible. Examining strategic plans and then actually putting it to action. And you think, well, how does that involve the district judge and maybe even the police? How it involves is the fact that we want kids to be active. We want kids to be participating in things so they don't get in trouble. And it leads to other better things in their lives: discipline, exercise, being involved, playing together on a team, sports. You know, I see my friends, Mr. Gaskeb and Chuck over there, who do such a great job, and our director of public works, Ms. Stolinar, who, you know, by the way, I'm sure I'll be sending you some community service people, right, Chief, to help fix some of these parks up. But the reality is, this is, as I said, just a great collaboration of people coming together, the trails, the parks. It's such a great day to be in Bethel Park once again. I'm such a proud resident of this community. There's so many good things going on residentially, business-wise, in parks and recreation, and it's a great day again for Bethel Park. Thank you so much for all the hard work and effort. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Judge. A big part of the community is for the last probably 15 years has been the Montour Trail. We thought it very important to bring them here today. They're going to talk about kind of the trail where it is today and what they envision in the future. We have been working with them through our Blueprint Bethel Park, which is our long-range plan to improve the mobility for our residents, and residents of all ages, just not those young kids doing community service. So at this time, I would like to introduce Bill Volbers, who is from the Montour Trail.
Thank you very much. As he stated, my name is Bill Volbers. I'm a volunteer with the Montour Trail Council and a volunteer that does a lot of the grunt work and maintenance work along our branch of the Montour Trail that's right here in Bethel Park. My family moved into Bethel Park in 1963 on Chessbriar Drive, not far from Brookside Lumber and the end of the trail at Logan Road. And I remember clearly, I was age 9, and if we missed the school bus, if we missed the bus, we'd gather up and hit the trail when the rails were still there to head, of course, uphill both ways to get to the junior high school because we missed that bus. But as the years went by, and my daughter Blair, who's here today, and I did a lot of running and walking along the trail, she learned to look for trails growing up here in Bethel Park because she enjoyed it and it meant something to her. And she recently was out in California and she described to me in a recent birthday card greeting how she had explored a trail through the very beautiful and significant Sequoia National Forest out there and in fact thanked me for planting those trees. So that was something she's carried with her for many years, and I want to look at today. Consider today, when you think of the Montour Trail here in Bethel Park, and it had gone bankrupt in the mid-1980s, someone in Bethel Park saw an opportunity. And they looked at that long, skinny stretch of grass, the old railroad right-of-way, after all that hardware had been removed, and had an idea or an inspiration. And that person is sitting right here in this chair with the Montour Trail hat on, Dr. Peter Conkey. So Peter got involved in 1989 with the Rails to Trails Conservancy in the United States. And it ended up, by the end of that year, he became the secretary of the newly formed Montour Trail Council. And since then, we've ended up with what we all know here now as our Bethel branch of the Montour Trail. So thank you, Peter, very much. And by the way, 78 years old, Peter, a week ago, we were on the trail together doing chainsawing, cleaning brush, gathering up litter and debris. He's volunteered like that every 2 weeks, every month for 40 years. So when you see him up there, say hello. Okay, over all the years that this trail's been present, there's been dozens of Bethel Park residents and volunteers involved, and they've done such a good job of maintaining that trail that the Pennsylvania Department of Conservation and Natural Resources decided that it was significant enough that we were awarded the Trail of the Year designation in Pennsylvania in 2017. And that's very significant. The commitment that it takes to earn a respected award like that just illustrates how committed Bethel Park views or is toward the asset of the trail being available for our use. And we have numbers now that show that there's over 400,000 people in a year that walk, run, cycle on our trail. Today, the municipality of Bethel Park and the Montour Trail Council are working together to make a whole new trail. It's going to be called the Central Bethel Park Trail. And it is a part of the Bethel Park long-range plan. This is good news for all of us, because if you look at statistics or studies, it shows that the second most important amenity that new home buyers look at in moving into an area is access to a trail. And that's current data. It's also been proven that having a trail adjacent to, in the heart of or adjacent to a community helps us all out with increased real estate values. The municipality is currently working on a plan to incorporate the new Central Bethel Park Trail in the mobility portion of the blueprint for Bethel Park. For example, it may be possible that they'll stripe the roads in the industrial park and connect the properties along the trail together through the sidewalk program over the next few years. So is the new Central Bethel Park Trail going to be ready this year or next year? No, it's not. But you can count on the fact that it, with help from all of the volunteers that are already involved and all of you that become involved, it'll be done sooner than later. So thank you very much, and please stop over, visit our tent over here across the creek. If you'd like to meet Peter and get an autograph, he'll be over there, or ask questions. And my daughter said I should say, may the 4th be with you. Have a good day.
I want to steal your speech. No, the Live Well Allegheny program is very important to us, and we thought it was important we do it as a community effort. We joined the Bethel Park School District. We have a great working relationship with them on a number of items, but this just enhances it. So at this time, I'd like to introduce Ron Werkmeister, Bethel Park School Director, to say a few words.
Thank you, Tim. Good morning. Thank you. Thank you all for being here, being part of this great day. What a great day for Bethel Park. As school board director, I'm honored to be a part of this great event, but I'm also honored to share a few words with you on behalf of our school board director, Donna Cook, who unfortunately was not able to be here due to some prior commitment. The Bethel Park School District is pleased to be able to have a close working relationship with the municipality of Bethel Park. This relationship results in the creation of many learning and recreational experiences that benefit our students and their families. Not every school district can say this, that they have this type of partnership with their community, but we are fortunate to have this ongoing partnership that benefits everybody in Bethel Park. We are also pleased to be joining the municipality partner in the Live Well Allegheny program. We recognize the importance that health and wellness plays in the vitality of our community, and we see that this initiative as a positive program for Bethel Park and an even better place for all of our residents. Most importantly, this new playground that is being dedicated today is a wonderful addition to our community, and we know that many good memories and friendships will be made here because of this project. On behalf of the Bethel Park Board of School Directors, I thank you for inviting us to be part of this great celebration. We look forward to participating in the many more projects of this nature, which will continue to keep Bethel Park a vital, progressive, and welcoming community for many years to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Ron. The program is coming to an end, but no. As I mentioned earlier, there's a lot of people, a lot of organizations that have gotten involved with Bethel Park through grants, through working relationships, and I would just like to acknowledge some of them. Some of them we talked about today, and some of them you'll be seeing in the future. But the Allegheny County Conservation District, the Allegheny County Health Department, and the Live Well Program, Allegheny Land Trust, which we announced our new relationship this morning, Municipal Council and Mayor, and without them, this wouldn't all be possible. Our Bethel Park Public Works Department, our Bethel Park Recreation Department, and our Recreation Board and the members here today, thank you for your service. The Bethel Park School District for their cooperation. It's much easier to work together and we can get a lot more accomplished by doing so. The Honorable John Marr, the Pennsylvania Department of Economic Development, the Pennsylvania Gaming Economic Development Fund, the Redevelopment Authority of Allegheny County, Sean Arbaugh, and St. Clair Hospital. They were all a big part of making today such a great day and a lot of planning for the future. I guess to kind of conclude, we do have some additional activities across, I'll say, the bridge and stream. St. Clair Hospital had some tables set up and some health screenings. They'll have a dietitian and talk about healthy living, an exercise therapist, heart health and exercise, blood pressure screening, respiratory and smoking sensation specialists for asthma, COPD, and smoking. So we want to say thank you to St. Clair Hospital. Please stop over. And if you would like to walk across, they will give you a pedometer so you can truly track how far you walk every day. And I would also like to thank the Montour Trail for not only being here today, sharing the vision for the future, but for Peter and everything you've done. And I know, Peter, it used to be phone calls and now it's emails, but Peter and the trail are very persistent and they don't want anything. They just want some help getting things done. So we appreciate all that. So on behalf of Municipal Council, all the elected officials, we thank you all for coming. Now, if the manager, police chief, and everybody would like to walk over, we're going to do the official ribbon cutting of the playground. And I think Mark O'Brien was going to ride the zip line. So thank you, everybody, for coming today and enjoy the great day. I hope you all are pleased with the direction we're going, and I would just ask that you get involved. Thank you.
All right. Can you help count us down from five? Four,
three, two, one.
Yay!
Thank you, everybody.
What a great day in Bethel Park. The rededication of Simmons Park is here. I have a gentleman with me. What's your name?
Chris Beekner.
And who do you work for?
I'm the president and CEO of the Allegheny Land Trust.
I heard that. You were explaining how you've partnered up with Bethel Park, and what did you create here?
Well, we haven't created it yet, but what we have is this 40 acres under contract that we hope to permanently protect as green space in Bethel Park.
I'm familiar with it because when I was first married, I lived in Castle Shannon, and I'd have to go by Connor Road all the time, and I saw this piece of land.
Yeah, it's right at the intersection of Route 88 and Connor Road. If you're coming down Connor Road to the T, it's straight up over the hill. It's 40 acres. It has...
And the slag dump was always there because I'm going back to the 80s.
Yeah.
And you could see that black slag dump, and now it's like reforested.
From the late 1800s to 1939, it was used as a slag dump, and nature has taken over, and it has full of black cherry and sumac trees, informal trail network on there, and it looks beautiful, and we look forward to protecting it.
And I actually knew some people that worked at Mine 3.
Did you really?
Okay. Yes, I did. They told me about it before it closed down.
Well, it's possible that we haven't picked an official name for it yet, but Molinaire Woods is a potential.
What a legacy that would be.
Yeah. So we're looking forward to protecting it. We're really excited to partner with Bethel Park. They've been great to work with us and the civic-minded organizations in the community. So we'll see if we can get this done by the end of the year.
Well, thank you for doing this, and thanks for the interview.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Have a great day.
You too. Thanks.
I'm Mike Doyle, and I have the pleasure of representing Bethel Park in Congress.
Welcome aboard now.
Glad to be here.
And I used to live on Robert Drive. You're on a street right before Robert Drive there.
In Forest Hills?
In Bethel Park.
Oh, in Bethel Park.
Your new office. So I know right where you're at on
88. 4705 Library Road. Come see us.
I wanted to clarify that.
Yeah.
Definitely. No, it's great to have you here. Great to have you collaborating with us. What a great day we have. We had sun.
Bethel Park's a great community. Didn't rain. It was supposed to rain today, but not in Bethel Park. This park is beautiful. I mean, the rededication is
My son played ball here and stuff, so have fond memories of watching games and doing activities at this park, and now to hear it, it's expanding is fantastic.
Yeah, I think any community would love to have a park like this.
Yeah, and it's really a great community here, and this is one of the center parks in the area. Mm-hmm. How could it not be?
Yeah, it's great. Baseball fields for the kids here, and the padding. Didn't have parks like this when I was a kid.
Me neither. I still got scars on my knees from gravel.
That's right.
No, but thanks for coming out today and doing this interview. Great. Anything else you want to
Bethel Park's about? A great community, and I look forward to serving it. And I hope folks, if they need any help on the federal level, come over and visit our Library Road office.
What weather we have today.
It's wonderful. It's such a beautiful day here in Bethel Park, and we're so
and
happy.
It's highlighting the rededication of this park.
It really is, and it really is nice to have a nice day for something like this outdoors. We want to get people outdoors and enjoy all our parks and recreation that we have here in Bethel Park.
It's a great theme. I'm a walker. I'm going to have to walk over this way.
You know, we should call me and we can walk and talk about sports and, you know, all
between
all
us
things.
Too.
Holy heck, yeah. We
that
we
could
have
be
some
a
good
marathon.
Conversations.
We might be doing marathons, 26.2 miles.
Yeah, I like it. I like it. Hey, that would be good for our minds and bodies, right?
Definitely. I'm
that's,
looking forward to that.
That's what this is all about, Al. I mean, this is about bringing the community together, leadership, the idea of all this strategic planning paying off.
Said a key word in your speech, mm-hmm. and I'm a guy that's a wordsmith, so I appreciate collaboration.
Collaboration, absolutely.
To see all the different groups get together in this day and age of so much discourse is amazing to me.
That's a great.
Because in this day, it's a downward spiral, not to get crazy,
no.
but people want to argue with you and hate you. Yeah. Here we have people from different walks of life, parties and everything else, collaborating for something good in our community. I'm proud of that.
I'm very proud of that. And wouldn't it be nice, and you said it best, and you're right, that word collaboration is a really good word. Because
great choice.
It brings people together. It brings people together, and it brings ideas together, and then it manifests in, hey, you know, we're making this happen. And
sure.
we're doing it in a time when, you're right, you know, sometimes civility isn't the greatest, but we want to see people coming
sure.
together. We want to work together. We want to move projects like this together for the better good of all of us.
And today's one of those days. Where you see people, Judge Arnone said a key word today, collaboration.
For sure.
Look at the people from different walks of life that are putting this together, and you included.
Yeah, absolutely. And it takes a community effort. It takes collaboration from the the school board, and then we have council.
Sure. I call it from A to Z.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
For sure. And then you get, this is what you
look
get
at this.
Yeah.
And I remember driving past that for years, seeing an old slag pile and how terrible it looks. Look what it's going to be.
Yeah, this is going to be pretty great for the community to preserve that space.
And look at our park increased by 24 acres here. This was beautiful and big before.
It's amazing, and it's easy to access for the residents, and it's a promotion of that healthy lifestyle that I think we all need in this digital age.
Thanks for being here and being a part of this great day. This reintroduction of Simmons Park, it's fantastic.
It's amazing. It's a beautiful place, and it's just exemplary of what people need, or sunshine, exercise, they eat right. Great
and
formula.
And I got my D3 today.
Oh, there you did. And it's just a great example of how to live a long and healthy life. So I'd just like to share with your viewers that my dad is 98 years old, moved to Bethel Park when he was three. And
he's been here 95 years.
Yeah, well, yeah, that's a little bit of a story. But, yeah, he was.
We'll say that.
Yeah, we'll say that. But he exercises every day. He eats right. And he still goes to work at Brookside Lumber Company. So
that is awesome. Thanks for sharing that. Tell me his name.
Peter Edwards.
That is great.
So he's a great example of how great exercise and eating right can help you have a long and healthy life. And I'm really excited about the park. I mean, it's a place for families to come and make memories and enjoy each other.
The ball fields, the park, everything here. Yeah. Activities are here. It's just great. I appreciate all your positivity. Anything else you want to add to this?
I have great memories sitting, going to picnics here and watching my daughter play softball. So it's come on in Bethel Park and enjoy the new park.
I heard you helped with an idea called the Montour Trail.
That's right. I got.
How did that happen?
Well, the longer story is that...
Short story.
Okay. I started in 1989. I got involved with the Montour Trail in its formative time. They needed a secretary for the board. And I was asked, Peter, would you be willing to be secretary? And I said, And it says, you're on. And so
I hired you with that speech.
That's right. And that the
you convinced me.
And for the next 4 years, I was the board secretary. Did
it all add up for you?
Well, I wasn't a treasurer. I didn't do any adding.
I had to ask that.
I just did editing and what happened, why, what's going on here, and
sure.
Recorded it all.
Like from point A to point B, and then
We have to talk to other people and figure out where the money comes from and how we're going to do this and how we're going to get around obstacles and stuff like that. So then I did other things, and I've been on the board most of the time since then.
Okay.
I'm sort of perennial one, and then I said that we need to have this trail come through Bethel Park.
Yes.
And my colleagues in the trail council said, oh, no, it doesn't go anyplace. It stops at Logan Road. Why would we build anything there?
Whoa.
And I said, it goes to my house. So I said, okay.
So you were the inspiration of it because of your house location.
Well,
partly.
I was also the nagger. I was the burr under the saddle.
Well, you need somebody like that.
That's right. And so then finally it became part of the concept plan. And so then we got some funding relatively early, and I was able to get it together relatively quickly to get the branch going even before it was always the mantra.
That's
always
a great story.
The mantra was always the main line. I always had to defer to the main line, but the main line had issues, whereas the branch was always ready to go.
Sure.
So that's why we built that. So now we built.
Thanks for sharing that.
We built the first section in 98, and we built the second, the one from Clifton Road South in 98, and year 2000 built from Clifton Road North to Logan Road.
Okay.
And then in about 07, we connected up in Peter's Township to the rest of the trail.
That's great.
And so now what
I've heard nothing but good reports about this.
Thank you. But now we're trying to see what we can do on the other side. We're sort of stymied by the industrial park and getting through there. Do we stripe the roads? What do we do? But then there are other pieces of land further north which are basically open and available.
Oh, really? That's great.
Now, it's not like a continuous piece of land like the little piece here. It's like a quarter mile here, half mile there, whatever we can do.
Pieces.
And so we're going to build these pieces is our plan. And with time, we're going to knit this all together.
You'll jump frog them
somehow. That's right. And as land becomes available, we will put it all together. Well, I live long enough to see a continuous trail there with bridges and everything.
Well, just between us, I heard you're 78. I think you got a good chance.
Thank you. Well, not
I'm an optimist.
Thank you for that support. But others are going to follow into my path and can do it for fruition. But I know if I don't get it started, nothing will happen.
Well, put it like this, as sharp as you are, I think you got 98 right down the road for sure.
Okay, thank you very much.
Definitely, because we'll do more interviews. And I interview your booth at Community Day, and you always have nice people manning your booth. And I have them talk a little bit about the Montour Trail on Community Day.
Yes.
Because I appreciate the good work and good deeds that you've done.
Do you use the Montour Trail?
I've walked on it a couple times.
Okay.
I'm a little further over where I'm at. I'm near South Hills Village. I walk the streets in my area.
I see. Well,
but there's no sidewalks on most of them. So.
Well, there you go. But check out the Montour Trail again at your next convenience.
I'm going to have to do that and move down there and get on that trail.
Yeah, but just move your body down there.
Yes,
yeah.
I will. Okay. I may have to drive to get to it.
Nothing wrong with that. We have parking lots.
I will use them. Thank you very much. It's been great interviewing
you.
Very good. Thank you for being a voice here of Bethel Park, and I mean, I appreciate all you do, too. I mean, I just want to tell you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Thank you very much. I appreciate the kind words that you have, and we've been friends for a long time.
Yes, very long.
And it's great to see you and part of this collaboration, the rededication here.
Very, very happy to be here. It's such a great day for Bethel Park. Like was stated before about kids with all their stupid phones and everything else, this is so important. I mean, if you look around, kids playing, I mean, this is what I remember.
Leave the phone in the car, start walking.
Leave the phone in the car. I mean, people go on vacations, and they're doing this and missing all the opportunities, and Bethel Park's got a lot of good opportunities around, and they're missing them. I mean, people don't even know about the park. I mean, that's
no, I'm with you, and this will put it out there. You had a great speech there. I enjoyed it thoroughly.
Yep, I thought thank you,
and it was well thought out, and I liked it.
Yes, thank you, and I know it was hard to do. It was actually Donna's speech, so I don't want to take credit for it. She wished she was here, but nonetheless, I was able.
Well, you carried on well, and good luck in all you do. I appreciate what you do.
Great. Well, thank you too,
and you take care, and thanks for doing this interview.
Yeah, glad to be here. All right, thank
take
you.
Care. Thank you. thanks for your collaboration and getting a lot of this stuff done and being on our council. No. I appreciate that because I'm a Bethel Park resident, so this directly affects me.
Directly affects me too. Born and raised here.
Really?
Six kids. Hadn't lived here. Got my grandkids here as well. I love it.
Nice. Yeah, I won't have you mention all their names.
No.
What do you see for the future here with this rededication?
So much going on. We have so many plans. That the blueprint,
give us a couple.
The blueprint for Bethel Park is really expanding.
Explain that a little, because I keep hearing about it.
Every 10 years, we're really expected to go ahead and come up with a, what's your game plan? What do you want to do for making the community
a better place?
A better place. Yeah, absolutely, across the board. So, developing businesses, developing infrastructure, developing our sidewalk programs, our parks, our rail trails. So it all falls into that. It's all piece of it.
It's great. We do need more sidewalks because we have what I call a lack of sidewalks.
We do.
Because I do walking in the neighborhoods and I'm in the street and on grass and all this other stuff.
And some communities, some streets aren't kind of built together to have sidewalks, but we have a lot of plan for how we can develop those further.
To coordinate stuff like that.
Beautiful. And connect them into the existing rail trails that we have.
No, that's awesome with these trails here. And expand the park by 24 acres. That in itself is unbelievable.
Almost doubled its size.
Yes.
Yeah.
Amazing. This was a great park before. I have fond memories with my kids playing ball here.
In the land grant today, how many green spaces are left in the south areas of Pittsburgh, let alone 40 acres?
Like you said about buildings showing up everywhere, whenever there's acres gone, there's 20 plans of houses in there.
Bingo.
Yeah,
spot on.
You see it all the time.
Yeah,
so.
Spot on.
Yeah.
And then as a doc, I want folks to do, it's part of this Live Well initiative with Allegheny, do what we can to just get folks more active and
get out and move.
Exercise. Eat properly. Take care of yourself. Go do your preventative medicine stuff.
I like your philosophy about preventative medicine because when you're putting Band-Aids on all these serious ailments, you got medicine and everything else following you, and it's nightmare after nightmare because there's side effects.
Spot on. As I said, it's a lot easier for me to, and it's a lot cheaper for me to prevent an illness than it is for me to treat it.
That's great. Well, thanks for doing this interview.
You betcha.
Keep doing what you do.
You bet. Keep it up.
Thank you. This guy graduated couple years behind me in Keystone Oaks. Yes, we're not going to talk about that, but please tell them your name.
My name is Mark Joseph O'Brien.
And what do you do here in Bethel Park?
I am a councilman of Ward 6. And I've
How
been the
could
councilman.
That even happen to a gentleman like you?
I've been the councilman here for over 28 years.
God bless you. It's great. I enjoy our conversations, and somehow they keep putting you in.
Well, the people have been very kind to me. I'm humbled by their choice.
No, you do a great job in the community. Mm-hmm. I must tell you that seriously, and I appreciate what you're doing and being involved in this.
Oh, my goodness. This is just wonderful. How things have changed, just in the equipment alone and the usage. We have a zip line.
Unbelievable. It's beautiful. I heard you're going on there.
I was already on it.
Were you? Yeah. I missed that.
Yeah, I can't wait to bring my grandchildren down here, Sophia and Brooke. So.
Wow, that'll be great.
They'll be loving it.
Coming attractions, folks.
Oh, yes, absolutely. And the basketball courts and the fields are very nice. And the acquisition of this property on the
other
side.
Doubling the size is amazing.
Acquiring any property in Bethel because, you're not making new land.
You don't have to tell me. Houses are up everywhere on there.
Yeah, and to acquire this property and then to acquire the property that I used to play on as a kid.
In Castle Shannon there.
From Castle Shannon. My dad had some friends that lived at the end of Valley, and we used to go over there and play in there.
You didn't play in that big slag pile, did
you?
Yeah,
we did. Yeah, it was fun. I mean, we looked at that property over 20 years ago. When it came available, when the Gutman property came up, and we only had the money to purchase one, and in the discussion, so
Get
we
on.
Decided to choose Millennium because it was more advantageous for building fields and recreation.
And the location of it there in the center of Bethel there is nice.
Yeah, plus the ingress and egress of that property has always been a problem.
I lived on Robert Drive, and there were plenty of bike trails and things up there, and we'd go up. Just wandering around at the animals. It was like a game preserve up there.
Oh, yeah. It was beautiful. And the view from that property. You can
Being
see
up
St.
High.
Bernard's
yeah.
in Mount Lebanon.
No.
All the way down Connor
kids
Road.
Out there. I go, we're going for a walk,
man,
and they love
just,
it.
To For Mr. Murray and Sean Arbar, a manager who went on, to entertain and bring this to council and have that discussion with council and everybody on board to do what needs to be done and see it forward without backing up to make sure this property stays green space is amazing.
Thanks for sharing that. That's great.
Oh, yeah.
I love the history just in general, and to find out about specific piece of land is just off the charts.
Oh, yeah. It was a great time. We have many great times ahead. This is a wonderful time. People starting to do recreation again. We're going to start infusing money into our parks to increase our recreation.
Sure, start moving, people.
Yeah, Village Green, Simmons, yeah. It's on a roll.
I know him as making the best dreamsicle that I ever had at the Dairy Queen in Bethel Park. This is, tell them your name, sir.
I'm Jack Allen.
The mayor of Bethel Park. He told me I'd like it. I got to try it in a blizzard now.
And we're looking forward to you coming up. In fact, I was just telling a gentleman, he said, do you have that creamsicle? I said, yeah. I said, try it in a blizzard.
Yeah.
So that's what he's
going to do. You got another one going to do it. Great.
I'm telling you.
You're starting a movement here, but this rededication day is fantastic. How do you order weather like this for events?
Well, for this time of year in this part of the country, it's a blessing.
Yeah, the sun was out.
It was.
Overcast a little bit.
And that's fine because the weather's nice. It's warm.
Nice little breeze.
And the park is great. I remember when I coached their softball,
sure.
The park had a lot to be desired. I mean, it was kept.
I remember back in the day with my kids playing baseball and softball here too. Sure.
Yeah.
It had its moments and a little rough edge here and there.
Yeah, and the flooring that we have
here.
I was walking on it. I thought maybe I had Dr. Scholl's in, and then I looked down. I said, no, that's the ground.
I know. This is amazing.
It is. And the zip line, I see kids on there all the time. I mean, this is the premier park.
Mark O'Brien was on there.
Yeah,
that's
what
he said. I didn't see it.
I think there was a weight limit.
I got to witness that. But that's what he said. No, you bring out some key points.
Yeah.
It's just great. And then to double the size of the park, to me, that's awesome in a community that you have.
And we're doing this to a lot of parks. We're upgrading a lot of parks. We put a couple million dollars in the budget just to do this.
Really?
And so this is one of the parks we've done so far.
What else? Which other ones?
The other ones are the neighborhood parks.
Okay.
Millennium, we're changing that up there. Village Green,
okay.
We took out the baseball fields, and now that's a turfed soccer field.
Get on.
So now
I'm going to have to go up and check it out.
And then we're putting another field up at Millennium. So we're updating that park.
That property up there is just so great how it's been developed.
Oh, it is. It is.
It is.
And luckily we have the opportunity to purchase property, like the 40 acres.
I know. That's incredible.
Yeah. And it's funny because we are, a community, an older community, and when people come in and they say, I want to build such and such, the first thing I look at it and say, where'd you find the land?
Right.
But there's some out here. There's
a few acres here, acres there. You know,
so
off Horning Road, they build houses up that way.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so.
Well, to give you an idea, just around the American Legion up there, they're going to be put 17 homes in there.
You're kidding, in that property there?
Yes.
I always wondered how that stayed vacant.
No, there's property available, and the developers find it. And what's nice is, 40 acres will never be, or should never be, developed. And that's the nice part about the announcement today.
How many people actually live in Bethel Park? Do you know that?
We have about, we probably have about 34,000.
Okay.
But we do have apartment buildings, and we can account for a lot of them. So we're at least 34,000.
That's pretty strong in a community. I always said around 30, so
I'll
update it to 34,000 because of you, Mayor.
That's about it. People are coming in because of the new developments we have.
Sure.
You know, we have the apartments up at South Hills Village.
Ashby. Yeah.
There's 305 units in there.
I know. The fireworks had to get moved out of there. My house driveway was perfect for watching it.
I used to go up the cemetery at the high school.
I'm right across from the cemetery.
And just watch them up there. So,
But
we do have our fireworks. They are back. This is our second year. We have them at the end of June.
I missed it last year. I heard it went great.
Yeah, it's a great day. I mean, we have vendors that come out. No Bad Juju is the band, which
I like them.
A big following. Yeah. So. We're doing a lot. The recreation department is heads and tails above anything else. So
sure. I'm glad I brought you on to give us these insights. You heard it here first, Bethel Park.